What is going on, you guys? Welcome back to another video, and in today's video I'll be doing my second album review on this channel, which is the new August Burns Red album, Phantom Anthem. It's their 8th studio album, and it was released today, October 6, 2017. Now, when it comes to this band, I'm actually a very brand new fan of this band. I was recommended to them by my YouTube friend, Zach D. If you haven't checked him out, go check his channel out, because he's really got some great videos related to music and everything like that. So, yeah, this band is very interesting because, like, a couple years ago, I probably would never have gotten into a band like this because I was not into unclean vocals. I was always more of a rock and roll type of guy. I didn't like screaming vocals whatsoever. But after I listened to the first single, Invisible Enemy, I was blown away. I mean, I didn't love the song at first, but it had to grow on me a bunch after listening to it about, probably listened to the song about 100 times now, ever since its release. And it's a really great song. I really love the pounding drums. The drum work on that song is really great. That's what caught my eye the first time, or caught my ear, I should say. Yeah, I like the vocals on that one too. Very intense, like I wonder what they used in the beginning of that song. I think it was probably some type of guitar tone or something. But the guitar riffs on this song are really great too. And a very good message too. It's about, you know, overcoming the enemies of ourselves, I guess you could say. And very good message, very great single to cut off the album. Or kick off the album, I should say, for the album release. And so, yeah, let's get into the album. Like I said before, I'm not a big fan of this band. Just because I've only heard a couple of songs from them, and I became a fan whenever the first single, Invisible Enemy, came out, and Zach D recommended them to me, so I haven't been a fan for not even that long, so I can't call myself a big fan, but what I've heard so far from them, I really, really like, and that's surprising to me because I am into more unclean vocals now than I was before, because back then I did not like screaming vocals or unclean vocals in songs, just because I didn't like it. It just put me off, like a lot of people in today's where they don't like screaming vocals, but they have to understand, you know, you have to like give it a chance. And that's what I did with this song when Invisible Enemy came out. I loved it. I still love it. So yeah, that's my history with the band. And so let's go over their sound. The sound of this album is pretty straightforward, I guess you could say. Pretty much just instruments used in here. I think there's some different ones other than the guitars, drums, bass, and vocals. But they do it very differently here. I noticed there's like a quiet to loud dynamic they use in some of the songs. Like Float, that one starts off pretty soft and then starts to get heavy again. And the dynamic, all around this album is a lot of dynamics and a lot of cool drum work. Now, I'm not going to go over every track just because I don't have much to say about a lot of these songs, but I don't think they're bad by any means. I just don't have a lot to say just because, like I said, some of them do blend together and others can be more forgettable, I guess you could say. But I want to talk about track one, King of Sorrow. This is the first track, and it's a little over 4 minutes long, and this one blew me away at first listen. This is one of my favorites off the album so far. It's just so, you know, powerful. I like the lyrics in this one too. A lot of great drum work. I think it's talking about, you know, King of Sorrow. It's like going into perspective, I guess, on someone that's, you know, living the high life and all they're feeling is sorrow. I don't think this is a Christian, I think they might be a Christian band. I know the people in the band are Christians themselves, but I don't know if they call themselves a Christian band, but a lot of these songs do have very, Christian type lyrics. It's not blatant, the word Jesus is not in any of these songs, but there are very, you know, most of these songs are very anthemic, very, positive, I guess you could say, in a very angry way. That's how they put it. But I really like the first track, King of Sorrow. That's one of my favorites. And then the second track, Hero of the Half-Truth. That's a really good one too. Pretty much the title explains what the song's about. You know, it's talking about a hero, I guess, and metaphorically it's talking about someone that's going through, You know, they can't tell the truth very well. They're just like going off and on, telling lies and truths and stuff. I like this one a lot too. It's very long. It's over, let's see. Yeah, it's a little over 4 minutes as well. And so pretty much the average runtime of this album is, the songs are over 4 minutes long. Maybe a couple songs that are like 3.5 minutes long, but most of them are over 4 minutes or 5 minutes long. So that's very good. I always like long albums. But sometimes long albums can be very, you know, monotonous. They can get, especially from a sound that's from metalcore. I don't like a lot of metalcore, but this band is really good at what they do. Them and Demon Hunter are probably my favorite metalcore bands. But this band does it very well, too. Another thing I wanted to mention about this album is that the songs seem, they look long. I mean, this album is 54 minutes long, and it's only 11 tracks, so these songs are definitely going to be long when you first listen. But I think August Burns Red executed it very well, because they don't feel like they're that long. They don't feel like they're 5 minutes, 6 minutes long. And I think they did a very good job on that, and it keeps you, you know, keeps you going, keeps you inspired to keep listening. And they throw in new things every other, you know, second. Different guitar solos, different guitar sounds, you know, different, you know, vocals. The drum work changes a bit. It's like very diverse, very good chord progression, a lot of these songs. And the lyrical content keeps you going throughout the tracks. So yeah, I just wanted to include that. I also wanted to talk about the second single that was released, which is called The Frost. A lot of people didn't like this one as much as the other one, Visible Enemy, the first single. But I really like this song too. It's grown on me a lot. I really like the intro of this one. It grows, you know, to that melodic guitar part, the lead guitar part, and then the drumming is like double bass throughout the beginning. It sounds really nice. Yeah, I don't love this song, but I do really like it, and it has grown on me. And so, yeah, it was a good second single, I guess. It's not one of the best on the album, but it does its purpose. That's why it's a single, I guess, just because it's more radio-friendly. But, I mean, it's still not radio-friendly, but it's more... It's lighter than the rest of the songs on this album, I'll just say that. And there's some other light ones on here, but like I said, they go from a quiet to loud dynamic on most of these songs. Like, they'll quiet it down a bit, and then they rise it back up with the guitars, and it starts to get heavy again. And I think one of these songs, actually, there's some singing in there. It doesn't sound like he's singing, but I think he really is, and I think that's very cool, too, because, you know, most... pretty much 99% of this album is him, you know, screaming and doing the unclean vocals thing. But you can understand what he's saying. But it was very cool to hear what him sing, too. And I think there's some type of shouted stuff in there, too. So, yeah. So after Invisible Enemy, a couple of the tracks afterwards are not as great, I guess you could say, as the first five songs off the album. But they're okay. They're not great or anything. But they probably just have to grow on me, just because I guess it's a long album. It's kind of, you know, monotonous sometimes. But after track 6 and 7, the next song, Generations, this is probably my top three favorite off the album. This is probably the longest song off the album, I think. Yeah, it's about 6 minutes long. And yeah, this song has everything you love about. I think this song pretty much encapsulates what this whole album is trying to do. It brings it together, and the song is pretty powerful overall. It's very great, greatly made. The lyrics are very good too. Love the guitar work on this song. The lead guitar is shining on this one as well, as a lot of the solos in this album are very good, I will say that. And yeah, I really love this song. It's very good. And so, and then after that we get into Float, and Float is not one of my favorites either. It's not bad by any means, but I do like the beginning part. Like I said, it's soft in the beginning, and then it goes to the loud dynamic. But during like the chorus and stuff, I mean, it does kind of get repetitive, I guess. And it's like I've heard this song before somewhere. And so, yeah, that's some of my problems I have with the album. But the good thing is we do go on a very positive note with the final two tracks that come back-to-back, Dangerous and Carbon Copy. They're one of the two of the best songs off the album, in my opinion. The latter of those, Carbon Copy, is a very great closer. It's one of the longer ones. I believe it's 5 minutes and 40 seconds. Yeah, that's right. Yeah, this one's a very good one. I like the guitar work in this one. Like I said, they have the quiet, loud dynamics they use in this one. Loud guitars, and then it goes to quiet. Same with Dangerous, except Dangerous is a different tone. I think it's heavier, in my opinion, unless Carbon Copy has some heavier riffs. But overall, Dangerous is a pretty heavy song, so there's nothing to complain about it there. I like the lyrics too, and yeah, they went off on a very good note off this song. I do want to talk about one more track, which is track 4, Lifeline. Yeah, this is a very good one. I love this one. This is probably my favorite off the album, and everything about it is pretty much fantastic. It's perfect in my opinion, actually. After listening to it a couple times, I definitely chose this one as my favorite. It's very anthemic, you know, the lyrics are very good, talking about lifelines and stuff. And like the vocals, the drum work. I have to say the drum work throughout this album is pretty fantastic. I love the drum work in this one. Very metal-esque drum work, a lot of double bass, you know, a lot of great using of the toms and the snare. Not in a bad way, but in a very good way. They know how to do it right, and it's very mixed very well, so yeah. Overall, guys, this is a very, very good album. If you're a metal fan or hard rock fan, you definitely should check this album out. Definitely gonna enjoy at least one or two songs off here. I think a lot of people will find something off this album. It's very diverse, very good guitar riffs, very good drum work. The drum work is very good on this one, too. Definitely check this band out if you haven't checked them out. I will definitely be looking into their other albums. I believe they have a Christmas album too, so I can't wait to listen to that during the Christmas season. So yeah, this is a very good album. So for my rating, I'm going to have to give it a strong 4 out of 5. And a moderate replay factor for most. And yeah, thanks for watching this review. If you like to like, subscribe, comment below on how I'm doing in my performance on this, if I can improve it. I know I'm still pretty new at this stuff, so thanks for watching and keeping up with me, and I'll see you guys in the next one.